In order to be versatile enough to communicate with a broad audience, it is vital to have a practical understanding of the different personality types that exist out there in the marketplace and how to communicate in their language. And by their language, I'm not referring to Spanish or French or Chinese. What I'm talking about is the different language styles of different personalities, because we all have a preferred communication style, and it's vital to understand how to adapt that style depending on the person we are communicating with. This is going to supercharge your video content if you understand who you are talking to, who your audience is. So in order to give us a framework to kind of filter the population through, I like to use the four different personality colors. And there's many different frameworks out there that you can use. No doubt you've probably done a personality test, maybe a DISC assessment, or maybe you're an ENRJ. There's a whole lot of them out there, and they're fantastic, very detailed. I love the four personality colors because it's extremely simple and very easy to learn and very easy to implement. So I'm going to take you through those four colors right now. Number one is reds. So red personalities are natural born leaders. They are very goal oriented, extremely focused. They are laser focused people. If you want to get something done, give it to a red person. They will get it done. They can be extremely direct in their communication, which the downside is they tend to offend many people. Many people think they're rude, think they're materialist because they are money focused and they are driven by those sort of ambitious goals and status goals. But that is just their personality style. So if you are communicating with a red, then you want to cut all the fluff. You don't need to beat around the bush. You can get straight to the point. And I love communicating with reds for this reason, because it's refreshing. You can just be completely honest and direct in your communication and not worry about offending them, because they're going to ask hard questions anyway. So you may as well come straight to the point. That saves a lot of time, and it makes it a wonderful way of doing business. So if you are dealing with a red person, recognize that and change your communication style to talk more about the amazing goals that can be achieved with this, the status that can be achieved, the money that you're going to make, the money that they're going to make, whatever it may be, those kind of things, not the touchy-feely stuff. So the next color is yellow. Now, yellow is the touchy-feely personality. Yellow is the mothering energy. It's the soothing nature. It's the introvert. It's the one who's kind of pushing the attention off themselves and onto everyone else around them. It's the one checking if you're okay. It's bringing you the chicken soup when you're sick. So generally, yellows are mothers, actually, or nurses or teachers or people in that role where they're caring for other people, because they are very emotional and very empathetic. And so your communication style with a yellow personality is the exact opposite as with a red personality. So with the yellow personality, you want to talk about your feelings. You want to talk about the emotional side of things. You want to talk about how many people you're going to help, or together you're going to help by collaborating on this project, or how good it is going to feel. If you're showing a house, then you're going to be talking about how the kids are going to have this space to grow up and how it's going to be so nurturing for them. You're going to speak in those words, in those empathetic words, and that's really going to connect with a yellow personality. Now, the third personality is a blue. A blue personality is someone who is bright and bubbly. They would be considered an extrovert. They love fun. They're very playful. They're party people. They have no problem whatsoever making friends. They like to talk a lot. They love telling stories and they love hearing stories. The biggest downside with blues is that they get distracted incredibly easy. So it's very hard to maintain their attention and keep them focused on you. So you need to be very playful and fun and talk about adventure and tell stories when you are communicating with a blue person. Blue people do not like details at all. So do not come at them with detail-heavy presentations, giving them all the facts and figures as to why this is a good decision for them. It will go in one ear and out the other. They're already daydreaming about something else. So you want to talk to them about all the exciting aspects of the property, of the product that you're discussing. So all the things that are going to be fun, all the things that the adventures they're going to be able to have because of what you're showing them. The fourth color, and possibly the rarest color, is green. So green people, maybe they're rare because they're definitely introverts as well, and they, well, maybe it's not so much that they're introverts, it's more that they don't know how to interact with people. They're the people who have no ability whatsoever to have small talk. They're socially awkward when you're at a function, and they much rather numbers, facts, and figures. They're generally mathematicians, engineers, those kind of people who are in their own world dealing with all the data. They're very data-driven. And as such, when you're communicating with a green personality, then you need to be communicating with all the facts and figures and information that you can load upon them. And even then, they'll probably still ask more questions and they'll ask for more information that you'll have to send them, and they'll go through and read everything later on. And that is the brilliant part about greens, is that they really do their research. So once they make a decision, it's a very solid decision. They'll be a customer of yours for life, because they have checked out every other option. They know that this is the best option for them. So that's the four different personalities. Did you see yourself in there somewhere? Did you see which color you are? Personally, I'm a blue. I'm much more extrovert. I'm much more playful. And I get distracted very easily from things. I like to tell stories. So I want you to imagine these four colors in the setting of a party. Let's just say. So a red would walk into the room, there's a room full of people and there's a circle that's having a conversation. A red would walk straight into the center of the coolest circle they can find, and they would start controlling the flow of that conversation. They would start being the center of attention there. A yellow would be off by the wall, by the drinks perhaps, just kind of trying to not be noticed, or maybe just talking with one or two people, sitting down at a table somewhere, very subdued. The blue would walk straight into that party, find the cool circle very much like the red did, and become the life of the party in that circle, or they would create their own circle on the dance floor somewhere. That's a blue person. You want them for a party. And the green person wouldn't even be there because they don't like interacting with people as much, and they had a whole lot of data that they wanted to go through at home. So that kind of gives you more of an idea of these different colors and their personality types. The activity from here is to work out who the people in your life are. What color are they? What color is your girlfriend, your boyfriend? What color are your parents, your siblings? What color are your children? Just go through and work that out. And they may be a hybrid. They may be a mix of that, because ultimately we are complex creatures and we're not just one color straight like that. Given different situations, certain colors may come to the front when required. I can be red when the moment is required, but majority of the time my default color is blue. Figure that out for yourself and for those around you. That is the activity to do right now. This is going to massively supercharge your ability to connect and communicate with absolutely anyone.